Hi everyone, my name is Hossam. I'm a nutrition student at Ryerson University. I would like to share with you today an apple orange delight recipe for dysphagia patients. But first, let's define dysphagia as simply difficulty swallowing, which may have serious effect on diet and contribute to malnutrition. Symptoms of dysphagia include drowning, choking, crying while or after eating, lack of gag reflex, trouble sucking through a straw, and upper respiratory infections. Patients suffering from multiple sclerosis, Parkinson's disease, dementia, and stroke are more prone to dysphagia. For patients with difficulty swallowing, thicker liquid is easier to get down, and that is because it moves slowly down the throat. There are three sections of fluid alteration in the dysphagia diet, which are coffee, tea, broth. These are examples of thin or normal liquids of no thickness. The second section is the nectar. It is a thick liquid with the juice consistency, and that's what we will be dealing with today in our food demo. And lastly, the honey thick liquid, which sounds like it is. It has the thickness of honey and slowly trickles down the throat. Now we start our food demo. Thank you. Now we have made our juice and strained it. I would like to teach you how to thicken it. We will need a measurement cup, a can of powdered thickener, and a whisk for that. It is important to provide accurate measurements so that the liquid is neither to be too dense or too thin. Now let's talk about thickening agents or thickeners. Thickeners are either starch-based or gel-based, and the difference between them is that starch-based thickeners use modified corn starch, which contains a lot of amylopectins that turns liquids into gels to build viscosity and to make them easier to swallow. On the other hand, gum-based thickeners, which we use today in our food demo, is an indigestible polysaccharide that also turns liquids into gels. It is recommended to use gum-based agents such as xanthan gum when dealing with liquids, and that is because it doesn't add any significant amount of carbohydrates to foods and drinks. It therefore maintains its original stability over time and doesn't cause the liquid to become lumpy. In conclusion, I have one final message for caregivers that they should try thickening drinks and meals away from the individual with dysphagia. If eating with others, try to serve everyone's meal at once. This can take a longer time than normal but it helps dysphagia patients feel like they are not alone and they can interact with others. Thank you. In this second video, we demonstrate chocolate pudding for dysphagia patients. Use cornstarch as a thickener to prevent any separating liquids from the pudding that may enter the lungs of patients with dysphagia, causing serious health problems or aspiration. To prevent any clumping of the cornstarch, we first mix the cornstarch powder with water, and that is called slurry. Make sure the slurry is very smooth before adding it to the liquid. And then we add it to the hot pudding and constantly whisk while adding. Now let us watch the video. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching our video, and please consult with your speech-language pathologist or your dietitian before trying any new recipe. Thank you.